So thank you for joining. It's 10:01. I'd like to go ahead and start right on the hour, just to honor those who were able to join us at 10, if that's okay with everybody. Just to check in real quick, make sure you have water if you don't already. Water really helps us get the energy flowing, so to speak. It also helps us to do more grounding whenever we're going into a meditative state. Water can just really help the process. So this is being recorded, as you guys know, and hopefully those who are able to join us but may have to join us a little late can listen to the recording. In the meantime, I'm Char Bowman Haskell, and really honored again to be invited to be with you all on this Sunday, the last Sunday of the month. And what I'm bringing to this process is one of the areas that I really find very, a large part of my life and very important to me is focusing on the chakras. Every morning I do a full chakra meditation that's about an hour and 15 minutes. And then I tap in throughout my days or my weeks or whatever on a particular chakra that might need attention. So my hope for what I'm bringing to the table is that you have more tools and more knowledge, or at least just an opportunity once a week or once a month to get in touch with a particular chakra and add that to your already broad practice within Reiki or whatever additional things you're involved in. So at this time, I'd like to go ahead and have everyone get as comfortable as you can in your chair, or if you're still reclining in bed or something, if you fall asleep, that's okay. That's what you need. But go ahead and get as comfortable as you can. And if anybody has any questions during the meditation, you can. I'll keep an eye, and Donna, who's helping us with this meeting, will be available as well for any questions. So if my volume is okay with everybody, I'll go ahead and get started. I do tend to get quieter as I talk, so I will try to keep that in mind and keep my voice going. So at this time, welcome. Take a moment to thank yourself for whatever effort, whatever means you had to, maybe a challenge or some sort of pushback to be present today, or just be grateful that you are waking up this morning and being part of the experience on the planet once again. Be aware of your breath. You don't have to force anything at this point. Just become aware of your breath, knowing that it's voluntary and involuntary. And thanking your body for its processes that you're aware of and that you're not aware of. We're going to be focusing on the sacral chakra this morning. And part of what the sacral chakra teaches us is to use the inner eye. And what that means is the sacral chakra helps us to focus on that which is within. So doing a scan within, is there any holding or tension? Is there any misalignment? Is there any pain or discomfort? And by bringing attention to it, but then most importantly, sending it love, understanding, acknowledgement, it can then be safely released and let go. So now at this time, start with your head, your crown chakra, and just do a gentle one more scan from head to toe, down through your scalp, your forehead, your eyebrows, your eyes, your cheeks, the back of your head, your ears, the back of your neck, the top of your spine, your throat, shoulders, shoulder blades, upper back, upper arms, down through your chest, your rib cage, your major organs, your torso in general, down into your waist and your hips, your pelvis, your upper legs, your knees and your lower legs, ankles, the tops of your feet, and finally the bottoms of your feet. Feeling the sensation of whatever surface your feet are resting upon. And if they're not resting on a surface, get in touch with the base of your spine and how it's connecting to whatever surface you're relaxed in, into. Once again, become aware of your breath. And if you feel you need to do a cleansing inhalation and cleansing exhalation, do that at this time. And now, once your breath returns to normal, allow your exhalations to help your awareness think deeper into your physical body and into your physical body's connection with the surface that it's resting on. Allow your exhalations to help you feel gravity do its work gently, firmly, and consistently, holding you to Mother Earth. Allow this grounding energy to reach deeper and further beyond your physical body, down into the floorboards, the foundation of the building that you're in, reaching and searching, just like roots of a tree, easily and effortlessly with your exhalations down into Mother Earth. And take a moment to check in one more time with your physical body to release any remaining holding or tension that may still be present. And just trust that you can let it go at this time. Now continue to bring your awareness deep into Mother Earth, imagining energetic roots extending down from your physical body through the soft soil layers of sand and clay, easily and effortlessly reaching down through the layers of bedrock, underground rivers, deeper into Mother Earth through more bedrock and the layers of magma at the core of Mother Earth. Easily and effortlessly through these layers, all the way to the very heart of Mother Earth. You can imagine, sense, or visualize the heart of Mother Earth being reflective, like the central sun, being a reflection of the central sun, bright, warm, nurturing, full of life force energy. Imagine, sense, or visualize your energetic roots anchoring permanently to the core, the heart of Mother Earth, in whatever way makes sense for you. And if you need assistance or feel like you need some guidance with this, you can call upon the angel of the heart of Mother Earth, Cassandra, to help you anchor and to be connected with the heart of Mother Earth. And at this time, allow your senses to become aware of your own heartbeat. And imagine, sense, or visualize the rhythm of your heartbeat is in sync with the heart of Mother Earth. Begin to imagine, sense, or visualize that you're bringing in and drawing in the power, the love, the life force energy that can be found in the heart of Mother Earth. Welcome it, open to it, and embrace it. Allow it to surround you and nurture you and your energetic roots. Now begin to draw in and draw up this life force energy, ever present, ever strong, unconditional, into your energetic roots with every inhalation. Just like water through a straw, accepting it and allowing it to come in and up. Drink it in. And with every inhalation, allow this energy to come back up towards your physical body, through the layers of magma, easily and effortlessly, back up through the layers of bedrock and underground rivers, bringing with it all the layers of Mother Earth that provide some sort of inspiration, nourishment, power. Drinking it in and drawing it up through the layers of clay and sand, soil, and back up through the building that you're in and into your physical feet. An important part of being grounded is not only reaching down into Mother Earth and connecting, but also allowing that energy to come back up and into your physical body. So allow this life force energy to reach all the way into the marrow of your bones, of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees, your upper legs, up into your pelvis. With every inhalation, allow this energy to reach up into your spine, every vertebrae one at a time. Into your rib cage, your torso, your heart center. Reaching up into your neck, your shoulders, down your arms, into your hands. And continuing up into your head, your skull, your jaw. And finally to your crown chakra, replenishing you, filling you with the life force energy and power of the connection of Mother Earth. Hold your awareness for a moment in your heart chakra and feel all the energy and the power that comes from being connected and grounded, and allow that energy to expand like a star in all directions. Radiating out, filling your physical body as well as your energetic bodies that surround you. The layers of energy beyond your physical body. As you radiate this energy from Mother Earth and bring it into your day and all that you connect to and with, feel that anchoring and that groundedness. Remember that you're always connected and grounded to Mother Earth. You just have to become aware of it when we need it. Be aware when we are not grounded. So part of that awareness comes from tapping in also to our sacral chakra. Our sacral chakra is part of our root chakra system below the heart. Some call it the lower dantian. This spinning wheel of orange light is our seat of power. The sacral chakra rules the bladder, the pelvis, the nervous system. Breathe into the sacral chakra at this time. And just like we expanded our heart chakra and brought the energy into it, do the same for your sacral chakra at this time. Breathing into the spinning wheel of orange light, or you can imagine it like a ball of orange light, a fiery ball of power, life force energy. Just in front of the base of your spine. Your lower belly. And just like we expand at our heart center, begin to visualize the expansion of this energy of your dantian, your sacral chakra, allowing it to expand and its energy filling your entire body. Imagining almost like a river of orange energy washing your entire body. Continuing to soften that which is hard or still or stuck or that needs to be released. Washing your bones and strengthening them, stimulating your power and the feelings of life force energy. Allow this sacral center energy to fill those areas of your body, your mind, your heart that may be held in fear or resentment or longing. For the sacral chakra can help us through feelings of isolation, emotional pain, and again, any sort of longing. Sacral chakra allows our body and our heart to trust. Trust and be held in the loving flow of life force energy that is our birthright. By expanding and tapping into the energy and the power of our sacral chakra, it allows us to wash away the feelings that no longer serve us and to release them back down into Mother Earth for healing. One of the practices of working with the sacral chakra energy is to help to visualize bringing in the energy of what it feels like to have versus feeling in a place of want, manifesting and feeling the energy of that manifestation. And allowing it to us to bring forward the power that's always within us at all times. So at this time, I want you to gently bring to mind something that you really want or desire in your life. Could be a situation, could be a person, could be an idea. This singular thing has the energy of manifestation around it. And the sacral chakra can help you to realize this manifestation, to bring it forward. And transform it from a state of wanting to a state of having. So as you bring to mind something that you really want, take a moment to once again tap into your body and notice how this feels in your body. Is there a particular part of your body that holds a sensation as you hold this desire in your mind or in your heart? Take a few seconds to be in tap with the sensation, to tap into the sensations and the qualities of what it feels like to hold this in your awareness. And now, using the power and the practice that we've already done of bringing that life force energy up into your sacral chakra, transform that feeling of wanting by imagining that you already have that which you desire, the desired result. So take a moment to shift into the feeling of what it is to already experience what it is that you want. What would that feel like? What sensations would change in your body? Imagine that it's already manifested and part of your daily reality. And feel into that feeling deeper and deeper, knowing it, becoming familiar with it and trusting it. And every time you feel that feeling waning, tap back into the power of your sacral chakra and ask it to help inspire and fill you again with the feelings of what that manifested desire is. Focus on it, become familiar with it, and make it more familiar than anything that you've experienced so far. Your body has the power to manifest this energy. Take another few seconds just to really feel the energy of what this having is, the reality of it. Hold it, expand it, let it radiate throughout your body and become familiar with it, to know it and to trust it. The sacral chakra can help you to continually practice this feeling, this vibration of the energy of having that which you desire at will, holding it in your consciousness for as long as you need every day. And whenever your attention goes back to the thing that you want, call up this feeling that you have right now, the vibration of having it, and connect with it. by recognizing the difference between the feeling and the energy of want, and the new feeling and the energy of having, you're creating a new energetic pathway in your energy field, easily and effortlessly, so that at will you can call this up, even automatically eventually, and manifest anything you desire. When you're ready, go ahead and take your awareness back to your sacral chakra, holding in your awareness this ball of orange light, this powerful set seat of your will and all that you desire. The sacral chakra asks us to feel what we want, what we need, not name what we want and what we need. The sacral chakra activates our internal eye so that we are always aware of the communication our body gives us at all times, the energy of that voice that we often forget and be transformed. Sacral chakra is the seat of our ability to create our reality, create anything and everything that we want. By activating our sacral chakra, we can move more easily, more confidently, and with more power through our entire day and our life. Some affirmations to recall for the sacral chakra if we need words to help us get to this space once again can be things like, I follow my gut, I follow my intuition. I sense and I feel my way through this situation, and I trust my body knows the answer. I need nothing from an other. I am simply here to be and to share. At this time, bring your awareness back to your sacral chakra and the expanded orange life force energy that it represents. Feel it and its connection with all the other aspects of your root chakra down into Mother Earth. And with this feeling of power and connectedness, strength, trust, and resilience, take a moment to call up to remember another want, for we will practice one more time transformative power of the sacral chakra from want to have. So imagine, sense, or visualize, bring to words if you need to, but especially the feeling of something you want for yourself, in your life, for your community maybe, or the planet as a whole. That singular thing, bring it to your awareness. And then when you're ready, begin to scan your body from head to toe, once again, identifying the feeling that this want brings to your body, conjures up in your body, using that internal eye that the sacral chakra helps us to get in touch with. And identify in your body the sensation that this want triggers or brings forward in your body. Could be a tension or a holding. Could be a muscle reaction of some sort, like a holding. Noticing where that energy is accumulating as you think about the want. What is the sensation or the qualities? Is it hot? Is it buzzing? Is it prickly? When we become aware of how this want manifests in our body and gives us those sensations that may not be so pleasant, bring your awareness back to the sacral chakra and that powerful ball of light and life force energy, allowing the sacral chakra to guide you and transforming the want to a have. And now imagine that you already have the desired result of this want. It's already manifested and a part of your daily life. Focus on the energy of having what it is that you want and allowing that sacral chakra, that power of the sacral chakra, to bring forward that having. What does it feel like? Where does it feel? Where does it show up in your body? Notice the energy of the having, how it's different and where it is, where it's accentuated, where it's accumulated. And sense the difference between what you felt a moment ago in the state of wanting to now that you have that which you want. And whenever this can be challenging to practice the difference in the knowing, go back to your sacral chakra, tap back into that energy, and allow that orange, powerful life force energy to flow through your body one more time to kind of reset, and then allow you to once again feel into the energy of having that which you want. And remember that feeling of having what you want. Remember not to get stuck on how things are going to transform from in your life, how things are going to happen. Just allow that vibration of feeling the sensation, the new, powerful sensation of having. Remember that vibration, that feeling in your body, so that you can easily call it up whenever and however often you need. For the sacral chakra is about trust, trusting the feeling of your power and your knowing. Trusting your power of creativity to create a new way of feeling about something, a new vibration of manifestation. No one can do this for you. This is alone your power and your ability. When we tap into the power and the connection of our body, grounded and rooted and supported and loved and nurtured by Mother Earth and whatever other sources of light and love that we find ourselves connected to and practice, bringing that energy into your sacral chakra and trusting your body to know what it feels and trusting that it can transform what it feels is what the sacral chakra teaches us. So at this time, take a couple minutes to once again tap in totally to your sacral chakra, seeing, feeling, sensing this ball of powerful light force and life force energy. And allow it to radiate out in all directions and fill your body once again with its cleansing, healing, inspiring, and strengthening energy. And now allow your exhalations to start to bring your energy back down and all that you need to release. Your exhalations, bringing your energy down through your body, down your legs, your knees, your lower legs, your feet, and reconnecting and releasing all that no longer serves you down into Mother Earth. Allow her own ability to transform whatever you need to release. And once we release all that we feel or we sense we need to release, it's important to draw back up that power from Mother Earth, the strength, and replace all that we release with the new energy of healing and love. So now ask Mother Earth once again to bring up into your physical body all that you need, whether you're aware of it or not, and allow your inhalations to draw up and in all that you need. And slowly become aware of your surroundings, the light, the sounds, the sensations on your skin. Allow your breath to be returned to normal. And then when you're ready, slowly and gently open your eyes and be ready to start your day. Again, if you have water close by, please make sure you drink. There's a lot of energy exchange today. Before we share, there is one thing that I wanted to share with you all. This is from Louise Hay's book, You Can Heal Your Life. And this is connected to the sacral chakra. I'll ask if anybody's interested in having this, I'd be happy to share it with you, send it to you via Alice. In the infinity of life where I am, all is perfect, whole, and complete. I am one with the power that created me. I have within me all the ingredients for success. I now allow the success formula and vibration to flow through me and manifest in my world. Whatever I am guided to do will be a success. I learn from every experience. I go from success to success and from glory to glory. My pathway is a series of stepping stones to ever greater successes. All is well in my world. Thank you, everybody. Anybody wants to share what they experienced? We have a few minutes to do that now. Oh, you're on mute, Barbara. I think I saw you say something.
Yeah. Thank you very much. You have a very pleasant voice. I just kind of drifted off. It was very nice. Thank you.
You're welcome. That's what we need sometimes, is to just drift off.
Yeah. This morning, I think my whole family needed this. There's a lot going on, and I definitely needed to start my day. And I know that a lot of my chakras have been out of balance, and the sacral chakra, but it was something I used to be really good at manifesting and having things, you know, kind of just flow to me. And in the middle of that, I was having a problem. And then the solution kind of, I got a text message that kind of distracted me, and it presented a solution. You know, it was funny how I was thinking about how I used to manifest things, and the thing that I needed really a lot right now, just during this meditation, presented itself.
Great. Awesome. Thank you for sharing that. Anybody else want to share what they may have experienced or have any questions?
That was a very useful and functional meditation. You know, a good number of very high level energy working skill sets wrapped into one experience. So I really thank you. It dovetails real nice with some of the studies I've been doing on my own up through just like yesterday's work. And it's a perfect kickoff for the rest of the week. So thanks. It's a really good one.
Thank you. Thank you for the feedback. That's great. I'm glad. This is what I personally get a lot of pleasure out of, but I forget to do it. And I think that's a self, sometimes what I put in the bucket of self-sabotage sometimes, forgetting that we have these tools are easy, and they're not necessarily easy sometimes when we conjure up things that are uncomfortable. But once we practice that transformation, it becomes easier and easier. And it's like anything else, is something we have to practice, you know?
Yeah. I thought that bit where you had us after we created the intention for something that we desired, and we were shifting from wanting to having, that bit on scanning our body to find the resistance spots physically and in our energy chart, that was a real useful thing that the other things that I'd been working with had not brought up. So thanks for that specific little element of what was overall a really, really good teaching. Thanks.
Thank you. Corinne, you had your hand up.
Yes, that was nice, but I felt a lot of tension on my root and sacral chakra, like kind of like resistance, kind of. It felt, as soon we started, I felt that really heaviness on my root chakra, and the sacral chakra helped a lot to dissolve a little bit that tension. So that was really nice. Thank you so much.
Welcome.
It was a lovely and relaxing, and I too reminded to think about what you want, not what you don't want, in the form of it was something that you said when you focus on what you want. That's what took me to that. But I went many places while I was there, but I can still hear you. But again, thanks. And also, I'd like to ask, I had already emailed Alice, I'm going on travel, and I needed to change the first Sunday with somebody if she hasn't already reached out.
Okay. Yeah, I think what I'll do after this is I'll connect with Donna and ask her to remind Alice, and then see who might be able to substitute.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for letting us know.
Char, that was wonderful. That was such a treat and a wonderful way to start the week. I agree that it was completely efficient and functional. I mean, that's just mirroring up these really complex trauma release and blockages with manifestation in a very succinct and easy way. And I wrote down two things that really stuck with me that you said. It's not naming what you want, but feeling what you want. And then one thing that sometimes I get too much in my head and I get paralyzed about making a decision, but it's the manifestation, the mantra of I can feel the way through a situation. My body knows the answer. And I just thought that was really prescient. So thank you so much.
We have a couple more minutes. Anybody else? Sorry, Andrea, go ahead.
No, I just wanted to say thank you, Char. I really needed to hear that message as well. And I forget to focus on the feeling of having what I want and not on the wanting. So that was very powerful for me. Thank you.
If I can just throw in, and thank you for that. I love it. It's Leah, right? I love anybody who can use the word prescient in the course of normal conversation.
Yeah, ours is a very cerebral world. You know, we often forget that we have a just a wealth of information and tapping in with our body. And I personally have to really ground myself all the time because I'm up here and, you know, tapping in with divine energy and spiritual inspiration and my angels and all that. I live a lot more up in here and also in the cerebral part. And I personally have to always remember to tap into that very strong and nurturing grounding energy. And so thank you for the opportunity to share this with you all. It really means a lot to me.
I would like to have that prayer that you said last. That I love it.
Okay, yeah, the one
that was nice.
Hayes book. Yeah, I'd be happy to share that. I'll send that on to
yes,
Alice, please, and Donna to share with the group. Sure.
Yeah, yes, you. That was really nice.
So before we end, anybody else have anything they want to share? Or otherwise, we'll hope to see you next Sunday.
Thank you.
I would like to know what that means, that heaviness that is still on my root chakra, so really, really strong. So how can I work through this? Because it's like, it feels kind of like a resistance or something like that. Like it's holding the past or holding something.
Well, let me ask you a couple questions about it though. Because sometimes something that's new can feel like resistance. So do you feel confident in your groundedness at any time? In other words, you might be feeling profound groundedness right now. And because it's not a familiar feeling, it feels uncomfortable, you know? So maybe tapping into it and asking your body to say, is this for my highest good? Is this good energy? Is this good grounded energy? And you're just not yet comfortable with it because it's not familiar. Do you see what I mean? There's a distinction.
Yes.
And just continue to feel into it and maybe see if there are other parts of your body that are matching a resistance, because there may be information somewhere else that can help you with identifying it more accurately. So in other words, feeling that heaviness in your root chakras, but then you start to feel a tension in your throat.
Okay.
Also. And so ask your throat, what is it that you need to express to me about this feeling of, is it dense energy? Is it heaviness in the root? So really allow your body to communicate with itself, if you will, in helping you just make the distinctions for that heaviness in your root. And sounds like it's easy. Oh yeah, let's have a conversation. It's not. It takes some practice. That's why I wanted to go through the cycle twice with everybody, because it is really something that does take some deliberate time. Mm-hmm. But hold on to that for a little bit as best as you can, Corinne, and just see, is it just the unfamiliarity with being deeply grounded and anchored into the energy of your root chakras and Mother Earth, or is it something that's telling you that needs to be released and transformed? Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much. That will help me a lot. Okay. Thank you so much. You're it was welcome. Pretty thank nice.
You. Thank you, everybody. Appreciate you being here. And I wish you all a blessed week. And look forward to seeing you again soon.
Thank you.
Thanks. Thanks again, Char. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Bye-bye.